Welcome to this gentle restorative yoga practice for lower body love. Today we will be using one block to support us in our practice. If you don't have one, you could definitely use a pillow or even just perform the postures without it, although it is going to help us find a little bit more ease and support us throughout these long-held postures. When you're ready, let's come into a comfortable seated position, Sukhasana. Take a moment to lengthen your spine. Close the eyes. Soften the belly. Relax your arms and your lower limbs. Let's gift ourselves this space to set the tone for our practice. Let us commence by taking three nourishing breaths together. Inhaling through the nostrils. And exhaling through the mouth. Sighing it out. And again. Inhale. And exhale. When you are ready, we will gently prepare for our first restorative yoga posture, butterfly pose or baddha konasana. You might like to take a moment to shake out your legs. And from here, we'll join the inner soles of our feet together, allowing the hips and the knees to splay wide. You have the option to stay upright in this posture, or if you like, you could lower down onto your forearms. Maybe relaxing your head here is enough for you. What could be really nice is to rest your forehead on your block. You can adjust the height of your accessory for more or less support. Now, if you notice any sensitivity, any tension or tightness around your knees, feel free to shift your feet a little bit further in front. This will reduce any pressure from behind your knees. We want to allow this to be a passive stretch. So softening the back body, the neck, relaxing your face and the jaw. We rest here in these postures today. You might notice that sensations begin to arise. This might manifest as a physical experience within the body. Maybe some tingling in the legs. Maybe tension or heat. Or maybe it manifests as an inner thought, an emotional response of frustration and agitation. Whatever comes up for you in this practice, really allow the posture to be a container for your experience. Allow the breath to help you move through these sensations in a space of stillness and awareness. Use every exhalation as an invitation to soften and surrender. Breathe in And breathe out. Let it go. We'll be here for about 4 to 5 minutes. So really give yourself permission to honor what the body is telling you today. Lovingly guide your awareness towards the breath. Gift yourself one nourishing breath in this butterfly pose. Allowing yourself to completely soften here. When you feel ready, mindfully use the support of your palms and your fingertips to help you elevate the torso one vertebra at a time, Roll the shoulders back and down. Close off the hips. You might like to place your block to the sides. Moving in any way that feels nourishing for you, you might like to fan your legs out from side to side. From here, we will prepare for our next posture, a yin yoga pose, deer pose. So we'll have our left leg in front, aligning left knee with left hip and left ankle with left knee. The foot is slightly flexed by creating a 90 degree angle, and we'll do the same thing with our right leg. From here, you can place your palms behind you. For a gentler stretch, you might like to angle your torso out on a diagonal, sort of in opposition to your legs. If you'd like to intensify the stretch, you can guide your back, your torso, a little closer towards your back leg. Now, you might notice a bit of heat, a bit of tightness around your outer right glutes, maybe the inner thigh. Really do your best to soften into this region. And while we are using the arms and the upper body to support us here, see if you can soften into the chest, relax the rib cage and the belly. Close the eyes if that feels comfortable for you. We'll be here for about 2 minutes. Allow the breath to guide you to a space of stillness and loving compassion. Gift yourself one more loving breath in our deer pose. Using this opportunity to relax the glutes and the hips. In your next breath, mindfully elevate the torso. You can stay where you are. I'm just going to shift my position for the purpose of this demonstration. So we'll keep the left leg in front. Extend your right leg back, point the toes as we prepare for our pigeon pose. Now you can give to yourself a moment here to stabilize the pelvis. It might feel nice to come out of the posture, reposition your knee. You might find it comfortable to guide your left knee towards the outer edge of your mat, or maybe it's more accessible to have your left knee facing forwards. If possible, we want our weight to be evenly distributed across the pelvis. Now you could stay upright on your forearms here, maybe place your block underneath your head, or it might feel nice to create a pillow with your hands and rest your forehead atop of them. This can be quite an intense stretch for the outer glute, the outer hip. So be gentle with yourself here. Give yourself permission to receive your unique emotional response. Breathe in and breathe out. Let it go. Gift yourself 3 more mindful breaths in our pigeon pose. With the support of your arms, lovingly elevate the torso, taking as much time and space as you would like. And from here, keep your left leg in front. Begin to guide your right leg across your left leg, taking a moment to stack your knees. For a gentler stretch, you can guide your heels close towards your outer thighs. Or for a deeper stretch, you can shift your shins forward so that they're parallel with the top of your mat. Now you might like to stay upright with a lengthened spine, resting your palms on your thighs. Or if you'd like, you can fold forwards and again find the support of your accessories. Maybe you feel that this posture is too triggering for today. And if that's the case, know that you could simply rest in a cross-legged position with your left shin in front of the right, and again find your forward fold. Give yourself permission to take modifications, to be compassionate. Gift yourself one more breath in our cow face pose. Gently elevate the torso. You might like to take a moment to circle out the head and the neck. You can place your block to the side, uncross your legs, maybe find some internal and external hip rotations. And when you're ready, we will prepare for our Deer Pose, our Yin Yoga posture on the other side. So this time we've got our right leg in front, our left leg is coming out at hip height, and we're finding our two 90 degree angles. Know that you can always adjust the angle of your hips, of your knees, to help you find more ease, more comfort here. Begin to close the eyes and settle in. Allow yourself to find softness within the parameters of your own experience. Offer yourself one more breath in our Deer Pose. Now really releasing any tension from that left leg, the left glute. When you feel ready, you can begin to awaken the body, elevate the torso. If it's comfortable for you, you can keep your right leg where it is, and we will begin to move our hands forwards, extend our left leg out behind us as we prepare for our pigeon pose. Taking any adjustments that you would like here. Maybe you stay up on your forearms, or perhaps you begin to lower down. You might notice that this stretch feels rather different compared to the same stretch that we performed with the other leg in front, and that's okay. Really just honoring what is unfolding here for you today. Allow the breath to anchor you into the present moment. You may choose to view each inhalation as a creation of space, as a creation of awareness. And each exhalation as a connection to harmony and inner peace. yourself one more mindful breath in our pigeon pose. Slowly begin to rise up. Keep your right leg where it is, and this time cross your left leg over your right as we prepare for our cow face pose. Maybe staying upright is enough for you, or if you'd like to soften the upper body and maybe intensify the stretch for the lower body. Allow yourself to melt forwards and let go. offer yourself one more breath in our cow face pose. On your next inhalation, gently roll up, uncross the legs, and take any movement. Maybe that means stretching out the hips. Maybe it looks like circling the neck and the head. From here, we will prepare for our next stretch, a wide-legged forward fold, Upavista Konasana. So we'll extend our legs out. For a gentler stretch, you can keep a smaller angle between your legs, between your pelvis. And for a deeper stretch, you might like to separate your legs a little further apart. You can definitely stay upright in this posture, maybe placing your palms behind your back to help you open the chest. And if you'd like to relax a little further, begin to hinge forwards. Maybe use the support of your block to elevate your head. Doing your best to soften into the lower limbs. If you're resting on your forearms, you might like to turn your palms to face skywards to help you soften into your hands, your wrists. Relax the belly. And let go. Invite one more loving breath into your body, into this experience. Slowly begin to elevate the torso. You can move your accessory to the side if you need. And we're going to lower down onto our backs. Guide your heels in close towards your glutes. We are going to come into a supported version of our wind relieving posture. So we will be using our block. When you're ready, raise the pelvis, the glutes, and with the support of your hand, place your block underneath your sacrum or your upper glutes to ensure that the pelvis is stable. You can play around with the height of your block for more or less of a stretch. And now let's guide our left thigh, our left knee in towards the chest. Interlace your fingers either around your shin or your thigh, and gently extend your right leg towards the mat. Soften your hips, the belly, relax the throat. Allow yourself to breathe with gentleness and fluidity. Offer yourself one more breath in this deep hip stretch. From here, you might like to circle out your left foot, your left ankle, finding any small movements that feel right for you. And mindfully re-bend your right knee, return your foot to the earth. Lower your left foot down, release the arms. Take a breath here. If you like, you're welcome to take a moment to readjust your block, ensuring that you feel safe and supported here. And now let's come into our wind relieving posture on the other side, Paramuktasana. Guide your right knee in towards the chest as you begin to extend your left leg, softening the hips. And while we are using our hands and our arms here to support us in this posture, see if you can soften into this region. Breathing in. And breathing out. Let it go. Offer yourself one more breath in this deep hip stretch. You might like to find some movement with your right foot, your right ankle. And when you're ready, return one foot at a time to the earth. You might like to stay here with both knees bent, or now extend your legs. You can find a gentle external rotation with your hips as your feet roll out towards the outer edges of your mat. On your inhalation, reach your arms overhead and rest the backs of your hands down on the mat. Let's take three gentle breaths here. Softening the belly, the hips, mindfully return your arms the length of the body. One leg at a time, return the soles of your feet to the earth. And from here, guide your knees in towards the chest. We'll prepare for our waterfall pose, Viparitakarani. Begin to extend both legs skywards. Know that you can keep a generous bend in your knees here. We're roughly aligning our ankles over our hips. Know that you can take a moment to adjust the height of your block, or if you prefer, you could perform this exercise against a wall. Relax your arms. You might find it helpful to turn the palms to face skywards. Soften the face, the throat, and breathe. Guide your awareness towards the breath. Take one nourishing breath here, breathing in and breathing out. You might like to point and flex your feet, maybe circle out your ankles, your feet, finding any gentle movements here that feel right for you. Mindfully re-bend your knees in towards the chest, and one leg at a time, return the soles of your feet to the mat. You can gently lift the hips, move your block to the side, and lower it down one vertebra at a time. Guide your knees in towards the chest. You might like to sway from side to side, or perhaps circle out the knees and the hips. You might like to find a gentle spinal stretch, guiding one knee across the body, maybe taking a breath or two here, and finding the same stretch on the other side. This is just an opportunity to find a bit of gentle movement before we prepare for our final posture of today, Shavasana. When you are ready, relax your limbs on the mat. Turn your palms to face skywards. Close the eyes. Feel your connection to Mother Earth. Feel your interconnectedness with this very moment. Allow yourself to breathe in and breathe out. Let it go. Gently guide your awareness towards the breath. I invite you to rest here in Shavasana for as long as you would like. You can pause the practice here. When you're ready, begin to reawaken the body. You might like to start by wiggling the toes and the fingers. Perhaps turning your head from side to side, or moving in any way that feels right for you today. With your eyes closed, gently bend your knees, roll over onto one side, and come up into our easy pose, Sukhasana. Relax your palms and your lap. Take a moment to acknowledge your practice. Thank yourself for showing up here today. On your next inhalation, reach both arms skyward, stretching the torso. Exhale, palms to heart center. If you would like to join me, we will round off today's practice with the mantra Om. Inhale to prepare. Om. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining this gentle, restorative yoga practice. If you enjoyed this practice, feel free to leave a comment down below, give this video a thumbs up, and of course subscribe to this channel to help support the continuation of free and accessible yoga.